Let's understand a little bit more about the parallels of latitude. So we discussed briefly in the previous video around globe for this, right? Now again, let's say this particular circle represents a globe. I know there are deficiencies because this part is flat and this part is flat. Now we discussed that, you know, there is an imaginary line which divides this circle into two equal half, and we call it the equator. Right? Then any line which is parallel to this equator, okay, and is basically used for referencing, a particular location, these lines are basically referred to as parallels of latitude, okay, all of them. We know this is the North Pole, the one on the top, and this is the South Pole, right? And we also know that the part above the equator is the Northern Hemisphere, and the one so basically above is Northern Hemisphere, and the one below is known as what? It's known as the Southern Hemisphere, right? So basically, if we look about the distance of the North Pole from the equator, if you look about this, is 90 degree. And do you know why it is? Now, this is a circle. So let's say if I were to basically form this entire thing a circle like this, effectively for this particular piece, this is representing 1/4 of the circle. And because one circle represents 360 degrees, so this is 90 degree, right? So we refer to these parallels of latitude in terms of degrees. So the one in the Northern Hemisphere are referred to as, let's say for example, if this is 20 degree north, we write it as 20 degree north latitude. Similarly, this is known as 40 degree north latitude. The equator is basically 0 degree, right? Similarly, you'll have 60 degree, you'll have 80 degree, and the pole is basically 90 degree north. Again, these are all north. The ones towards the South Pole, the South Pole is what? It's 90 degree south. You would similarly have 20 degree south, 40 degree south, 60 degree south, 80 degree south, and the 90 degree is the South Pole itself. Again, the distance between these two is 90 degree, right? Now we spoke about some of the standard stuff, right? There are certain other parallels of latitude which are important, and let me take you through them, for which I will just briefly erase all this data, right? So we'll just remove whatever we had written. Now let me take you through the other important latitudes. So you have something towards 23 degree north, right? And similarly, you have something which is 23 degree south. This 23 degree north latitude is known as Tropic of Cancer. And the one which is on the south is known as Tropic of Capricorn. Another important one is 66 degree north, right? And 66 degree south. The one which is on north is known as the Arctic Circle. And the one in the south is known as the Antarctic Circle. Now you must be wondering as to what exactly is the reason, why this classification, right? So let me tell you about that as well. Now if you look at the area between 23 degree north and 23 degree south, which is this particular piece, Okay? Here, what will happen is that the sun rays during the midday are exactly overhead on each of these latitudes. So midday, the sun rays are exactly overhead at least once in a year. And that happens only during this particular region. Right? So this zone is also known as the torrid zone. Now coming to the next one, which is the area between 23 degree and 66 degree north, which is this one, and 23 degree north south and 66 degree south, which is this one. This is known as the, let me just use a different marker, the temperate zone. And here the sun is not exactly overhead, but the angle keeps on decreasing. So these are also known as temperate zone. As you move from away the equator, the impact of the sun rays keeps on decreasing. And the balance one, which is this remains, which is here. Here basically the temperatures are very low. Why? Because the sun barely rises above the horizon. What do you mean by that? So let's say for example, this is the land, the sun will always be something close over here. If you talk about this region, the sun is somewhere over here. It's at least overhead at least once a year. For the mid area, it is somewhere over here. So it keeps on declining. And for these areas, it's actually very close to the horizon. And therefore, the temperatures in these two zones, beyond the Arctic Circle and the Antarctic Circle, are very cold. Right? And therefore, these are also known as the frigid zones. So beyond the Arctic Circle up to the North Pole and beyond the Antarctic Circle up to the South Pole. So effectively what I'm referring to is these two areas. So there's a lot of ice over here. That's why I've painted it white. These are known as the frigid zone. I hope you would have got a bit of a knowledge around the parallels of latitude. Thank you for being with us today.